In this hosting review, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about hosting before deciding if you should get started with this web hosting provider. I will break down the pricing structure and show you how to get the best deal currently available. I will guide you through the entire sign-up process and judge how easy their platform is to use. I will then grade their performance based on page load speed and uptime from the hosting and plan that I purchased. And lastly, I will provide you with the pros and cons and my honest recommendations on if or who should buy Hostinger. At the end of this video, I will give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up Hostinger through my link below. I will give you my six-figure blogger course for free. In this course, I show you how to set up your WordPress website the right way, how to adjust and tweak settings for optimal website performance, and how to start driving traffic and make money from your site. Now, let's get straight into this review. Click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It will take you to my special hosting a discount page where you will get the best discount hosting is currently offering. I also have a special custom coupon code that you can use to get an extra discount, and I will show you exactly how later in this video. Full transparency, this is an affiliate link. I will receive a small commission at no extra cost to you, while you get a special discount and my six-figure blogger course for free. So it can be a win-win situation for the both of us. And I just genuinely appreciate you supporting the channel. Now, I will be comparing their shared hosting plan, although Hostinger does offer other types of hosting like cloud and VPS hosting, so they can support you when your business grows and you are ready for an upgrade. And Hostinger offers three different shared hosting plans. With the single tier, you are limited to just one website. However, on the higher plan, you can have up to 100 websites. Another notable difference is the SSD storage for the single plan is just 10 gigabytes, but increases to 20 gigabytes on the premium plan and 100 gigabytes on their business plan. The bandwidth between the plans are also very different. For the single plan, you will only be allowed around 10,000 visitors per month, then it increases to 25,000, and then 100,000 on their highest plan. A great free bonus which Hostinger provides on their two highest plans are the free domain and unlimited email accounts. And lastly, a worthy feature which Hostinger provides on their highest plan is the free automated daily backups. Many companies don't provide this feature at all. Some provide it at an extra cost, but Hostinger does have it for free for you on their highest plan. So overall, the decision is very simple to make really with Hostinger. If you only need one website, go for the single plan. But if you are just starting out but need multiple websites, then the premium plan is the way to go. Lastly, if you're migrating from another host where you already have websites with lots of traffic, then I would highly recommend you choose their business plan. So now I would choose their business plan for this tutorial to test them out. On the checkout page, you can see there are four different pricing options depending on how long you want to buy the hosting for. So I myself always recommend and would always buy the longest plan as it will give me the cheapest per month price. There is not much point buying it for 1 month, 12 months, or 24 months when you see the price of 48 months is only $3.99. Once you have chosen your hosting provider, which you're happy with, not saying that it's Hostinger yet, you'll normally stick with them for a very long time. But if hosting is not right for you, then you always have their 30-day money-back guarantee to refund your whole purchase and get all your money back. So I'll stick with this one for here and go down to the payment section. And this is where you can get the extra discount by using my coupon code. So if you go and click on have a coupon code and enter in .com/dollar into the coupon code section and click the plus button, you can see the price has been further reduced from $191 to $178 from their already discounted price. So if you do want to go ahead with Hostinger, I do recommend you use this coupon code for your extra discount. And now you fill out your payment details and click on submit secure payment. The overall pricing score I would give Hostinger is a 9 out of 10. They are a really cheap hosting provider starting at just 99 cents per month. and they are really transparent with the usage limits which are allowed in each hosting plan. They also use Lightspeed Cache for WordPress on all their plans, which is one of the best and most efficient ways of speeding up your WordPress website right now. This technology is not available in many hosting providers. They are mostly only available to a more high-end hosting service. So well done to Hosting here for bringing this feature to all their customers at a very affordable price. I did take one mark off them as they don't offer the automatic daily backup on all their plans. You will only get it on their highest business plan. This is something I believe is very important for users, and web hosting providers should always provide them as a standard features on all their plans. Right away from their hosting dashboard, it looks very simple and clean. You can add a website easily or go to manage the website you want to work on. And once you're in the domain's dashboard, you can see it looks very easy to navigate with the custom hPanel interface compared to the cPanel that a lot of other hosting providers use. The design is also very clean and simple. Now let's see how easy it is to install and create our WordPress website. So now we go back to hosting one more time and click on manage. Now we can scroll down to auto installer, click on that, select WordPress and fill out the information that you want here. I'll add the title, and if you're happy with everything, then go down here and click on install. Now give it a little bit of time, and I'm going to fast forward this bit until it's done.
And what about installing an SSL certificate? I will show you that now too. If you click on the search button and type in SSL, you will come down and click on this SSL button here and then click on install. And that's it. It's all done with one click of a button. Very simple. Now, what about creating an email account? So you simply just go to email, click on email accounts, and we come down to here and we just put in the name we want. Now type in your password, then click on create. Okay, it's that simple. You can see our tests at alanborge.com has been installed. So the three things that I showed you how to install were very easy. They were all one-click installs, which is really good from Hostinger. Overall, I would score Hostinger a 10 out of 10 for setup and ease of use. I really can't fault them on anything in this area. I think all users, especially beginners, would love how clean their new interface is and just how easy it is to navigate and do things to your site. I personally think this is one of the cleanest user interface out of all the ones I tested it so far. I'm very impressed with Hostinger here. So after I have installed the basic WordPress site, I went ahead and tested out the speed of the bare bones website using GT metrics. The result is 1.4 seconds. This is a great start. Even though this is not the fastest in my tests, I must say they are very close. So now I would take it a step further and add some design elements to it to increase the page size. And don't worry, if you're overwhelmed looking at this, my course that I will provide you for supporting the channel will guide you through this step by step. I'm also going to install some free plugins to speed up the website. First, I'm going to install WP Fastest Cache, which is for the speed optimization, and Short Pixel, which is for image optimization. And lastly, I will install the free Cloudflare app, which will also increase the website performance with their CDN. This will make it more comparable to what you would do in real life. The speed is now 3.2 seconds, which is once again not the fastest compared to the top performing ones in my test, but it is still around Google's recommended site load speed of 3 seconds. Hostinger still has one thing up its sleeve to try and get under that magical 3 second mark, which is the Lightspeed Cache plugin. Now, if I replace WP Fastest Cache with Lightspeed Cache plugin, which is recommended by Hostinger to be the best free choice, the speed is now 3 seconds flat, which is just a pass with a 0.2 second improvement from before. Now, I have been monitoring the stability performance of Hostinger with Uptime Robot and can report that their uptime for the last 30 days is a perfect 100%. In fact, they have not had any downtime for over 50 days in a row, which is very impressive. Overall, I would rate Hostinger's speed and uptime performance an 8 out of 10. I took 2 marks away for their speed, as it was a fair bit slower than the fastest hosting providers I tested. Their uptime reliability, however, is second to none. So well done to hosting it on that part.
Here's a quick question for you. What is your current page load speed and who is your web hosting provider? Let me know in the comments section below.
Hosting and provide customer support through email and live chat. I would test them out by asking them these three different questions on live chat. First, I would tell them that I have been infected by a virus on my website and ask for their help. The second question is I ask them a quick question about their domain name renewal costs. And the last question is I ask them if they could do me a favor and install the SSL certificate and Cloudflare for me, as I am a complete newbie and have no idea how to do this. Here are their results. One, they were willing to look into it right away and did a quick scan for me manually. They don't provide a malware removal service, but offered to restore the previous backup version without the virus for free. For the second question, I found out that they don't have live chat for potential new customers trying to contact them, which is pretty disappointing for me to find out about this, as I expect all hosting providers to have 24/7 live chat support as a minimum. So I had to send them an email instead, and it took about 28 minutes to reply. So this wasn't that good either. And for the third question, they were willing to help and did everything for me right away, and it only took them about 15 minutes to finish everything for me, which I was really happy with. With regards to their response time, I contacted them at three different times of the day to make sure I get an overall average and not just a biased fast response time during their off-peak hours. So the three times were 9 minutes, 28 minutes, and 4 minutes. The average of those three times turns out to be 14-minute wait, which is definitely a little too long for me. I think the max wait time for any hosting company should be kept to under 5 minutes. Overall, I would have to score Hostinger's support a 6 out of 10. I would say their support overall was average. It was nothing great, but it wasn't the worst either. Their team was actually knowledgeable, but they had a pretty bad response time at 14 minutes. When compared to other hosting providers. They also lost more points from me because they did not have 24/7 live chat support for new customers looking to sign up with Hostinger.
Do you like the level of detail I'm providing you in my review so far? If so, make sure to like my video and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on high quality tutorial videos just like this, which I release every single week.
So let me first start with the cons. I only see one main negative of Hostinger, and this is their support staff's response time was not good and were not able to provide the level of service compared to other top hosting providers. Their live chat support is also not available for new customers looking to sign up with Hostinger, which is a negative here. The first pro that stands out to me is Hostinger's speed and performance. They have a decent website speed performance compared to the price you pay for the service. And their 50 days straight of no downtime is amazing in itself. They are a very reliable hosting provider. The second big pro is their intuitive backend system, which I believe is much easier to navigate and use than cPanel. This may not be a big deal for someone who has been building websites for a while, but it is a big plus for beginners just starting out. The next pro is the fact that Hostinger has 7 different server locations around the world for you to host your website on. This will greatly increase your website speed for your visitors if you or your business are located outside of the United States. And lastly is their pricing and their transparency. They don't really try and upsell you anywhere, and they also have one of the cheapest shared hosting prices going around.
This is a quick note regarding my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up Hostinger through my link, you simply just have to send me your receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I will send you access to my bonus course as soon as I can.
Overall, I have given Hostinger an average score of 8 out of 10. They are a solid and reliable host with a very clean user interface and acceptable speeds. So this is my recommendation for you. If you are a beginner looking for a cheap hosting provider and an easy to use interface, then Hostinger is a very solid option that I think you should seriously consider. However, if you are more advanced and are looking for more features and better performance, or want better support, then I don't think Hostinger is the one for you.
Now, I think picking the right hosting provider is such a crucial step for your business. So if after watching this review, you think Hostinger is not the right hosting provider for you, then I recommend you check out this hosting alternative, which is my number one recommendation and I use for myself. But if you're happy with Hostinger, however, and you're ready to proceed, then I recommend you watch this next video and I'll see you in that next tutorial.